Good morning, students. This is the sixth video of the chapter Nazism and the Rise of Hitler. And this video has been made for class 9. Now let us discuss the Nazi World War. This is the subtopic of this chapter. So here in this particular video, we'll try to understand that what was the viewpoint of Hitler towards the society, towards the world. Or what made Hitler the Hitler? How he was influenced by some belief or some ideology? So we need to understand here that Hitler became the Hitler because he was influenced by some ideology. When he was in school, he was under the influence of Charles Darwin and Spencer. And here in the school only, he came to know about the theory survival of the fittest. And after that, that particular ideology was implanted in his brain. And thereafter, he joined further as a soldier. And finally, when he got opportunity, he tried to implement the same ideology with whom he was associated. So let us discuss about the Hitler racism. So Hitler, when came to power, he adopted the racial discrimination in his own country. He followed the policy of racism in his own country. He categorized some people as superior class and some people as inferior class. Now, according to the Nazi view, only strong race could survive and rest will perish. But the question was, which race will be considered the superior race, or which race will be considered the inferior race? For that, he identified particular group, particular people with certain physical features, and thereafter he termed them superior class or superior race, and rest the other groups were termed as inferior race. So according to Hitler, here it is mentioned Nordic Aryans were considered the desirables for the society, or the strong race or acceptable race in the society, whereas other groups like Jews group, Polish group, Russian group or Gypsies were termed as the inferior race, and they were termed as undesirables. So Hitler himself categorized the society into different, on the basis of different race, superior race or inferior race. Now, one more concept is here associated with the Hitler, that was Lebensraum. So what was the particular Lebensraum concept? Was that its English meaning is living space. So Hitler was of the view that whatever resources are available, it should be available for the strong race only, and inferior race should be perished, it should be wiped away, and the resources should be available, and all the people, those who are from strong race or superior race, they should enjoy the free space. So how the people will enjoy the freedom? Once they will get more space to travel, once they will get more space to live in. So that is why Hitler's concept was to accommodate or to capture nearby territories. And that is why he moved towards the eastern side. And he tried to capture the nearby areas. So his basic plan was to expand the boundaries of Germany. When we were discussing the French Revolution, we discussed the dream of Napoleon. The dream of Napoleon was to expand his territory. Similarly, here also, and here the dream of Napoleon was to expand the boundary of France. So here also the dream of Hitler was to expand the boundary of Germany, and Germany borders would include almost all the European countries as well as Russia. So it was a dream of Hitler, and in order to fulfill that dream, he moved towards eastern side. But when he moved towards eastern side, he first of all captured the Poland, and he made it the experimental ground. And further, we all know that this led to further conflict and it finally turned into the World War II. So let us discuss again his ideology. So Hitler became the Hitler when he got influenced by some ideology. When he was in school, as we discussed, that he got some ideology, and with that ideology, he grew old. And when he got power, when he came to power, he released, he particular implemented that particular ideology. He imposed certain things in the society that was not good for different type of groups. In order to understand that how he created racism in his own country, we need to understand that Hitler classified the society into two groups, desirable and desirable. Undesirable and desirable. I mean to say, those who were necessary for the society, those were termed as desirable, and those who were undesirables, they were locked in a particular place that was termed as ghettos. So ghettos were basically the enclosed place which was completely separated, and in that particular place people were kept who were not Aryan, who were not from Nazi group. So basically the group, the Nordic Aryan group, was termed as the Nazi group, and another group was termed as the Jews group, Polish group, and Russian groups. Got it? So we need to understand here that this is how the country, the Germany, got divided into two parts on the basis of racism. And here the opportunity was given to only one race, that was the Nordic Aryans or Nazi group. Because Nazi was the political term, so here we need to understand here, Nordic Aryans were the group which was termed as superior or desirable group. Whereas other groups were, so Hitler was a very clever man, he was a tactful diplomat also, and he made plan to execute one by one all the undesirables from his country. First of all, he implanted the seed of hate in the mind of his school children. And he was knowing that when he will grow old, he will not be able to control the citizens. So that is why he targeted school children. And he targeted the school children in such a way that when they will grow old, they will follow the orders of Hitler. And they will not disobey the orders of Hitler. So this is how the racial discrimination was started by Hitler, and further it was expanded all over Germany. So as I told you that Poland became lab for experimentation, we need to understand here that Poland became the important part. Poland was captured by Germany, and in the Poland only many execution camps, concentration camps were located. Ghettos areas were built, and in that particular area the Nordic, the Jews group, the Polish and Gypsies group were targeted. I mean, first of all, they were separated from the society, they were locked at some confined some special place, and after that they were completely executed. So here we need to understand that Jews, Polish and the undesirable group were targeted. They were connected, they were imitated, I mean to say they were presented as a mouse, as a harmful animal for the society. And this is how they were neglected from the society. I mean to say it was the complete planning of Hitler that executed one society or one class of race or one particular race from the Germany. So it was his plan, and he implemented his plan in certain steps. So we need to understand here, we need to understand that how he executed his plan. Finally from 1933 until 1939. So we'll discuss that what exactly happened in this period, how he planned execution of Jews group, particularly because Jews was considered number one enemy. This group was considered the most undesirable group, and it was not that he didn't target his own Nordic Aryans also. He did, those who were not fit, physically fit, they were also targeted. So Hitler was very clear, those who are fit, those who can survive, those who can adapt, they will live. And for that, he adopted his strategy, racial discrimination. And finally, we discussed that in between 1933 to 39, he laid out his plan, and the plan was laid out in such a manner, that execution was done in a very planned manner. First of all, they were separated, the Jews group and other groups were separated. They were locked at some place, and after that they were killed in a gas chamber, because it was not possible to kill thousands or lakhs of people all together. So that is why Hitler chose a gas chamber for mass killing or genocidal killing. So this is all about this topic. So I hope that you have understood this topic very well. Thank you so much.